Solar owners are furious. They feel betrayed, to be punished after they just answered to market signals and government incentives. Authorities and energy suppliers are furiously rowing back, as if they are seeing an approaching tsunami. So there you are. But instead of being angry, even if it's justified, let's look to a solution. Hi, Norbert here. I'm energy engineer, and in video number 96, I explain how you can let your solar power system, your balcony system, stop feeding energy into the grid. Many solar owners feel betrayed. They have a solar system on the roof, so rather big systems, and now you see that they are not treated well. And I show new solar enthusiasts how they can start small and leverage the very low prices of solar panels that they find in the DIY stores, and how to do that with a battery. To keep the solar power into your house instead of putting them on the grid. Look also to video number 63, where I talked already about the principles of the microinverter, which is synchronized with the grid. Be sure to look first to that video and then come back here. I think that the existing solar owners of the big systems on the roof can also use these principles. I will tell that at the end of this video. And yes, I'll get back soon to the supercapacitors also. I was this week even more busy than the week before when I used this excuse also. But okay, that's just the reality. I had no time for the experiments.
But my brother in Belgium already has a full rooftop PV system. He is very frustrated. He has to pay a prosumer tax each year.
Yes, exactly, and that was in Belgium. But also in the rest of Europe, there are many not so funny situations. For example, in my home country, they were very used to the solderingsregeling, that is a kind of a situation where you can use the grid as a big battery, and that will soon be over. And in Germany, you have to have a roof system of at least 10 kilowatt, and then you may export. And otherwise, you arrange yourself with a battery or so, a home battery. And also in Australia, there are grid export limits, and so on over the whole world. But what is generally true is that the tariffs for your electricity to the grid are very low.
Hold on. You're saying I can just plug a solar panel into a normal socket and it powers my house? That sounds like snake oil, man.
Yes, but it is real. If you use a microinverter between the PV panel and one outlet of your home grid, it synchronizes with your home grid and it offsets your consumption.
But that will never happen with only one or two panels on your balcony. With $150 that I pay each month, I think it will all be consumed by ourselves.
Often it is more than what you consume on the moment. For example, your refrigerator and the router of your internet, they are always active, but many other things not. So there are many moments on the day that it is less, even if you have only a solar balcony system. So for example, if you buy in a DIY store two panels of each 2 square meters, then you can have 600 watts at good moments. Well, not today. And the rest of this power goes onto the grid, and you don't want that. Or you must store it, and during the evenings, well, then you must buy again this power which you gave in excess. And then it would be good that you can store this power and take it back from your own system in the evening. And that's the way to use 100% of your PV electricity yourself, instead of playing around selling and buying again. And then you lose.
So how do you store it if the PV panel goes directly to the grid?
Well, you can do that by not putting the micro inverter to the PV panel, which is normal, which the market also offers you, but put it on the battery. The micro inverter doesn't care about that if it's a battery. Just look to the input parameters, the voltage, etc., and it's okay. So what you do, you first charge the battery with this solar panel. And then you go with the energy from the battery to the microinverter, and that goes into your grid. In that way, you decide when the power flows and also where. It saves much more, and you can use all the energy which you make with your solar panel.
Then why isn't everyone doing this?
Yeah, that's a good question. There are three reasons that people are not using it in this way. First thing is that people think that just a microinverter, you put it on a PV panel, and they are not made for batteries. Well, if the market is suggesting that, okay. It just means that we will go the extra mile with DIY. And the second thing is that feeding energy into a grid often needs a permit, and that keeps people away. Certainly in these times that energy supplies are so difficult. And anyway, if there is a blackout, and that is a general rule that is everywhere in the world, that your system must not give electricity onto the grid, because that would be dangerous for the people that are fixing the grid on that moment, because there's a blackout, yes. So that is something that requires really a certification of this inverter. And the third reason is that people are just afraid of electricity.
Yeah, like if I plug a panel into my wall socket and it's live, isn't that dangerous, those bare pins?
Yes, of course, it is dangerous if you use the wrong inverter. But as I said, certified microinverters, they check the grid and shut down instantly if the grid fails. Moreover, if the plug from the microinverter is not in contact with the grid, then it doesn't feel the grid and it will not work. It's the plug of your dishwasher.
Let's be honest. Energy suppliers and policymakers are quietly rowing back. They say green transition, but who pays the price? You do. You, with panels on your roof, producing clean energy, and still feeling powerless. And still, there are also new potential solar enthusiasts. We need you too, because the energy transition is still at its start. That's why Norbert is here, to give you real options. If this video until now gives you ideas or hope, please support his hard work and his unique position in YouTube. Give him a like, subscribe to the channel, or drop a comment. And if you know someone else stuck in this mess, a neighbor, a friend, send them this video. It is multi-language, so it is useful over the world. Let's build energy freedom together.
Thank you very much, Sam. I appreciate your support. I really hope that this can become my full-time job. Then I don't have any more excuses of too much other work.
You're welcome. And now, what about those portable power stations? Aren't they safer? They also have solar input.
Yes, there is one. And yes, they are safe as long as you don't connect this outlet to the grid, because then you get a lot of sparks and a bad smell, because it's not synchronized with the grid, nor certified to do that. Moreover, the reach is also limited. A plug-in system powers your whole house, your fridge, your router, your washing machine, your television, the first floor, the second floor, every outlet and every light point. They all get free energy, and you don't have to worry about if the power is enough for the washing machine. It just adds up to the energy that comes from your meter. And with a portable power station, you don't have this. You just have one place, one location, one plug.
But they sell this plug-in solar also with batteries. I saw one modest system, about $2,000.
Yes, exactly. That is also the reason that I am proposing this DIY solution. First, because there are very few of them which can store and also synchronize with the grid. Well, let's see the advantages in a row. It is cheaper. And second, you are also more flexible because you can pick the battery that you like. And then it works with a standard microinverter, and I took Hoy Miles, which works well with a battery too. It can work also off-grid. So that's ideal for developing countries and also campers. So just choose a regular inverter instead of a grid-tied inverter.
So, one setup for on and off grid?
Yes, nearly. I didn't explain still how you get the system so far that they will not export energy to the grid. How do you do this measuring and control? So you take the energy from a battery, and then it will go just all the energy which it can find in the battery, it will go to the grid without any limitation. So you have to limit yourself the current. And how do you do that? Well, it's just the same as a solar panel. If a solar panel gives less energy because there is a cloud between the sun and you, then the panel gives less and it will give less to the grid. So what you can do is just you limit what goes inside this inverter. Now, and every micro inverter works in this way. So if you do this, that you control the input, then you are okay with any type of these microinverters. So, and that is the thing which I will also do with the microinverter which is coming in the next days. And then you don't need a special band, you don't need to search for input where you can say how much energy it has to make in this moment. You don't need fancy microcomputers, or you have not to program APIs, etc. You just do it in this way, and then you have, of course, you need a sensor from the grid. That's just a magnetic sensor that you don't have to touch the electricity. You embrace the conductor, and then you can measure how much power goes in from the grid into your house. You adapt the production of the microinverter to that. I will show that in the next videos.
But will the energy company be okay with this?
No worries. They will not see anything because you don't export anything to the grid. And of course, if there's a blackout, then this, they are certified that they will absolutely not give electricity when there's a blackout. My model is the Hoy Miles HM600, and it has two completely independent units of 300 watts. And for each of these channels, it has the MPPT. So in order to optimize what comes, what's the panel able to produce. So if you do this all behind the meter, so at your end of the meter, then it's all completely legal. And it works well because it's a good market. So you can find it on the whole world. You can see also the link in the description. And it works from 23 volts. So that is something that I saw some video from Germany. So if you put two batteries in series, 12 volt batteries, car batteries in series, then you get at least 24 volts, and that will just work. And of course, I will make a review of this inverter.
Okay, now I'm intrigued. This could be the start of my solar journey?
Yes, I would say start small. And you can even use your existing panels if you are already a PV owner with a big system on your roof. And as I promised at the start of the video, that I am thinking also about you if you have this system and you cannot sell it anymore to the grid. Just in a moment I will say what you can do. And of course you can also start just if you don't have a system yet, then you can start this year. We are now in spring and the panels are very cheap in the DIY shop. For example, you can get for 150 euros or dollars, you can get, two panels of about 300 watts already. Two panels, 300 watts. And that is what you can use for this Hoymiles HM600. So that's if you are new, if you make your first experience with solar energy, then you can do this. You buy just two big panels and you start with this system and a battery. And I will show you in next videos how. And to come back to the homeowners that have already a big system on their roof and they are frustrated, what you can do, one of two things. You can just start quickly and take in some way isolate one or two panels or four panels from your existing system. You just take the strings and then you will connect them just outside. You take them off the official system that is grid connected, which you don't have under your control, like we don't have under control our system in Sicily, which is also connected to a grid and will not even charge the battery if there's a blackout. And we got really a ridiculous amount of money for this 6 kilowatt plant that is producing energy during 6 months in the winter when we are not there. So you can take one or two panels from that system and connect it to your own battery, and that battery you can then connect to the micro inverter. And why to take another battery? Well, usually it is a little bit complicated to take also the battery, if you have a battery on your home system, because they work closely together with the official inverter. So if you can do that, I will try it in the summer also to do it with our batteries, then there you are. But from now, what I can say now, conservatively, what is certainly possible is that you just take the connections of the different panels and then you connect them to your own battery and your own microinverter. And the second solution for those homeowners, if they don't want to mess up their existing system, then just buy these panels in the do-it-yourself shops, because really you see the prices, how low they are, and then you can start with that. And if you like the experience, then you can start also to take one by one the panels of your roof. And it's your system and it's time to take back control. I wish you good energy.